Hey girl, it's Johanna with God is Glamorous, where we learn how to live our best lives through Jesus Christ. And today, we're going to learn how to study the Bible. All right, girl. So first off, I want to congratulate you for taking one of the first steps to grow closer to God. So reading the Bible is one of the best ways to learn all about Jesus and all about your Heavenly Father. And I just want to say this is going to be such an amazing journey, and I'm so proud of you. I want to start off by saying that sometimes the Bible can be a very, very complex book. So when you're opening the Bible to start reading, I want you to know that this is a marathon, not a sprint. And although the Bible can be intimidating, I want to let you in on a little secret. No one knows everything about the Bible, and no one ever will. It is something that needs to be consistently searched with all your heart. This is something that is just constantly explored, and there are some mysteries, and there are just some meanings, and it's up to your own interpretation sometimes, and it's just something that just allows you to grow closer to God spiritually and just be able to connect with God in your very own way. So I also want to let you in on a little secret. This book is not just a narrative. This book is also filled with poetry and songs and letters. So when you're reading this book, it's really, really important to understand the context in which you are reading it. I also want to remind you that when you are reading the Bible, make sure that you understand that there is no perfect way to study the Bible. The Bible is your own personal spiritual walk and your own spiritual journey with God, and never look to the right or to the left to figure out what other people are doing. Everyone has their own different techniques to study the Bible, and as you get closer to God, you will have your own different way in which you plan to study the Bible. But the first thing that you should do before you start reading the Bible is to be intentional. And how do you become intentional before you start reading the book of the Bible? Well, the first thing that you need to do is go to God in prayer. So before you start reading the Bible, it is very, very important to go to God, pray, and ask God to reveal something to you, or to give you wisdom to understand something, or to give you a heightened sense of awareness of what He wants to show you. Sometimes when you are reading the Bible, you may have a specific destination that you want to study, or maybe you just randomly flip open and discover something. Maybe you just take a look at Proverbs and look at all the different pieces of wisdom it can offer you. Or maybe you start in Genesis and see how the world began. Or maybe you take a look at the New Testament with the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. It's totally up to you. But it's just really, really important to be guided by God and to just allow God to give you that direction that you need when you want to study the Bible. So as a new Christian, you may be asking yourself, well, where the heck do I start? That's a very good question. So Christianity is all about Jesus Christ, right? So one of the best ways in which you can start studying the Bible is to take a look at the New Testament, which starts with the four Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, which are all accounts of Jesus's life. So we have the Old Testament starting at Genesis, and then we have the New Testament. So the Old Testament is everything before Jesus, and the New Testament begins with Jesus and everything beyond, up until the book of Revelations. So that's a good place to start as a Christian, as a believer, just getting to know who Jesus Christ was. And here you will be able to understand all kinds of teachings of Jesus. Also, anything written in red is exactly the words of Jesus Christ. So you'll be able to actually see how Jesus spoke and what He said and the different ways in which He taught people. So definitely starting with Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and just going through that is the best place to start. You may also want to start at Genesis and just get to know God's characteristics, starting with Adam and Eve and how God was able to speak to Adam and speak to Eve and how God created the world. It's truly, truly fascinating. And also just learning about how God was able to speak to His creator, His creations, how He spoke to Noah and how He spoke to Abraham, and how He was how he led the children of Israel out of Egypt with the help of Moses. And it's just really, really, really incredible. So if you want to learn more about God and God's personality, I would start at Genesis. And also, if you want to start learning about Jesus and Jesus' personality, take a look at the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John in the New Testament. There are also some other great chapters. The book of Proverbs is incredible. It's all about the book of wisdom. So if you truly want to learn how to gain more wisdom, definitely check out the book of Proverbs. Definitely check out the Proverbs 31 woman. She is incredible. And it's just a description of who the virtuous woman is and how you're able to emulate her. And if you ever get stuck on where you want to study, definitely check out the Bible app. I have learned so much about the Bible from the Bible app. They have all kinds of plans that you can go to just to give you a basic foundation. So if you want to start with reading the Bible, they have Bible plans for new believers, or they just have plans of different Bible stories that you can go to. But essentially, there's truly no way to start, no right way to start. You just have to start. You just have to pray and ask God to give you that wisdom. So again, I recommend starting with Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John and learning about the teachings and the characteristics of Jesus, his birth, his resurrection, his death, and also starting with Genesis, and learning about God and how he was able to create the world. So that is the best place to start. And then after you get through those, get the Bible app and go through their plans and just get on that journey of learning how to continuously seek and learn to grow in your faith and learn about God and Jesus and how to expand your Christianity. So also, this book that I have is called the Women's Study Bible, and this Bible is incredible. I will link a description below of the link. I get no commission. I just really love this Bible. Literally, all my girls have this book, this Bible, because I've recommended it to them, and it's just amazing how it breaks down different sections within the Bible. It backs things up with facts and dates, and it's just incredible. So I've learned so much about the Bible from this Women's Study Bible because it just has all amazing footnotes and just different sections that highlight and explain different things within the Bible. So definitely get this Women's Study Bible. It truly, truly breaks down everything that you need in order to fully understand the Bible. So as mentioned before, let's start in the New Testament with the book of Matthew. So as you can see from this Women's Study Bible, it has a full backstory of what this book is all about. So it lets you know who the author is. It gives you the date. It gives you the background of the book, the setting, the purpose, the audience. It gives you the literary characteristics. It gives you major themes. And one of my favorites, it gives you an actual outline of everything that's actually going to take place within this book. So it has four different sections, and within these sections, it has different details of these sections. So the four sections are the Messiah's coming, the Messiah's unveiling, the Messiah's manifesto, and the Messiah's passion. And throughout these sections, it talks about Jesus' birth, his genealogy, his admirers, his escape to Egypt, his baptism, the temptation. It's truly, truly, truly incredible. So definitely take a look and start there. So that is one of the first steps that you should take. So this will be a series on how to study the Bible, but I just wanted to give you a general backstory of what the Bible is and just understand that this is truly a journey. Lastly, if you want to learn more about Jesus and God, definitely click the link in the description below to get my free ebook, Passion to Profit. And be sure to like and subscribe so that you never miss another video. I post every single Monday and Wednesday. All right. Well, thank you so much for watching. Be sure to check out these videos to learn more about Jesus, more about God, and more about stories in the Bible. And I will catch you next time. Stay glamorous.